Now, here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Britain's Hotel Chocolat after it agreed to a $662 million takeover offer from U.S. food giant Mars. This sent its stock skyrocketing over 160% in midday trading. Also in focus, shares of Burberry after the British luxury fashion retailer warned that full-year operating profit will come in at the low end of forecasts amid a global slowdown in luxury spending. Burberry shares plunged over 9% on that news. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of German meal kit delivery company HelloFresh. That's after the company cut its annual profit forecast on the back of weak sales growth and rising costs in North America. Shares of HelloFresh tumbled nearly 23%. Asian markets ended Thursday trade mostly lower as fresh Chinese data showed prolonged weakness in its property sector. The Hong Kong Hang Seng lost 1.3%, while Japan's Nikkei 225 shed a third of a percent. Speaking of China's real estate crisis, a court auction to sell vast commercial land plots owned by the defaulted Shimao Group in Shenzhen failed for a second time Thursday, highlighting weak demand in the property market. Shares of the group slumped 1.5%. In other notable stock movements, the Hong Kong-listed shares of EV maker XPeng tumbled nearly 4%. That's after a disappointing third-quarter earnings report. Meanwhile, shares of Xiaomi plunged 6.5% as its debut into the electric vehicle market seemingly failed to excite investors. Here at home, Philippine shares saw modest gains, with the main index picking up a third of a percent.
Values and volume are not improving, actually, Stanley. We're seeing levels that we haven't seen in decades. Now, fortunately, it's something that sort of we cannot understand why, but obviously we're looking at really low valuations right now. Concerns on inflation and interest rate is no longer a primary concern. It's more of geopolitical concerns. But right now, even the Middle East crisis seems to be contained. And we're also going into the seasonally strong market.
The Philippine Central Bank leaves interest rates unchanged as expected. The BSP retained its benchmark rate at 6.5% during Thursday's meeting of its monetary board. Now, this decision follows its off-cycle rate hike of 25 basis points in late October. It cites moderating inflation expectations and tighter financial conditions for keeping rates steady. This as it lowered its forecasts for the consumer price index until 2025, projecting it to be near the 2-4% target range by next year. But it notes inflation risks remain tilted to the upside, and that's why it isn't closing its doors to resuming its tightening cycle.
The Monetary Board noted that keeping the policy rate steady will allow previous policy interest rate adjustments, including the interest rate increase in October, to continue to work their way through the economy. Looking ahead, the Monetary Board continues to deem it necessary to keep monetary policy settings sufficiently tight until a sustained downtrend in inflation becomes fully evident and inflation expectations are firmly anchored. Key upside risks are associated with the potential impact of higher transport charges, electricity rates, and international oil prices, as well as of higher than expected minimum wage adjustments in areas outside the national capital region.
But for economist Juven Paracuelles, the BSP is done with its rate hiking cycle. He also sees rate cuts by September next year.
Where they will be hawkish is on the language. As we saw, the BSP needs to signal that they stand ready to resume hiking, because obviously if they pivot too early, and this is what the governor Eli is saying, that if you do that too early, I think the risk is inflation risks start to pick up again and inflation expectations start to be affected negatively. So you don't want, as a central banker, you don't want that to happen because the job gets harder, right? So I think they'll be a bit more cautious when it comes to the pivot. And so, again, it will be all about inflation and when it returns to the 2 to 4% target. Once it goes below 4% and BSP feels a bit more comfortable that it stays there and it's more well-entrenched, then I think they can start cutting. So for me, that's in September 2024. And again, it will be a sort of a gradual cutting cycle to ensure that inflation stays within the target range.